So welcome. This is the second time in my life I use a PowerPoint. I don't like PowerPoints, but it's up the way I have to do it now. I need a paper, so that keep me on track. Otherwise, I talk for hours, and then, okay. I have only 45 minutes. So I will tell you a story about Eduscrim, a way how we can change education. And most important thing, how can we create an agile mindset by the students? But most important is, before the students, you have the teachers. And teachers are difficult people, very difficult. I'm a teacher. I'm Willy Wijnands from the Netherlands. Yeah. Okay. I'm Willy Wijnands from the Netherlands, and I'm a teacher for 43 years in the same school. I'm a science teacher, and I teach from 11 to 12 to 18 years old. And I still love my work. My students love me because I give them a lot of freedom. So they can choose their own topics within borders. So what is Eduscrim? Eduscrim is a way. Eduscrim is an educational process where the students work in teams in a fixed rhythm, like the PDCA cycle, and they determine how they do their work, and I give them only the why of the assignment and what they have to deliver. So from a teacher-driven way of working to a student-driven way of working. And it's very easy, what you saw on the picture before, or you can see it also here, when you don't use it as a trick, and you don't put the students, or train the students not in a good agile mindset, then you can't, they understand the why about Eduscrim, and they can't fly. And Eduscrim is not about the behavior, it is a process. And this, you start with chaos. The chaos, we create the chaos like the mountain, the iceberg, like this. And we put a lot of thoughts, we put them in stories. Question for you, who is a teacher? Okay, and the rest, scrum coaches? Who is scrum? Scrum coaches, scrum master, product owners? Okay, I will change my my presentation. how it started? A friend of mine, Mark Rijn, works in had a workshop from Jeff Sutherland in his company in the Netherlands, and he told me this with a bottle of beer, and this was my scrum book. This was my paper where I started about how works Scrum. So this was the way I started in August with my students with this only paper. But why we have to change? Why we have to change education? Our world is changing very fast. Scrum is invented by IT. Business, but not only the IT business is changing very fast, but also the educational stuff is very fast. You are not the teacher anymore. Only sending out. It must be a communication in between. And what we did before, and not in Turkey, but in the Netherlands and all over the world, we teach like in the 20th century, like the old school system, like the industrialization, and it works very well. So, but we can't make the gap between the old school system and the new way of the company's need. We have a gap, and how can we use the gap? So, by training the students in the mindset to be agile, and bring them Let them work in teams. And working in teams is a very difficult way of working. And what is for you the most difficult thing when you work in a team? What's the most difficult? What is difficult?
Idea conflict.
Yeah. Conflict, yes. Conflict. I call it in a positive way. Communication. Communication can have conflict, but it's also you need it. And I go to the next. When you give an assignment to the students, but also for yourself, this is all about the why. Everybody knows this, this golden circle from Simon Sinek, I think. Who knows this? Okay. I make this a heart of it. And you know, when you know him, you know also the five whys. The why come from your heart. I teach with my heart, with my passion. And the why is now for me, I determine the why. I determine the what. And the how is for the students. The students determine their own way of working. I must give them also a target. Because I have also to listen to the Minister of Education. He gave the exam rules, and there's old school system. But I still have to listen to them. But we must change the way of what is most important thing. What is the most important thing students have to learn nowadays? What? What is the most important thing? Knowledge? Knowledge?
No,
knowledge you can find on Google. What is the most important thing is creativity. Creativity is the most important thing we need. And next to that is also critical thinking. So, critical thinking and creativity must be in the assignment. This gives the students freedom to make their own way of working. Critical thinking to make them students, not only they go for the money, but they go, sorry. You know, it's the second time. Yes. So my finger here. So critical thinking and creativity is the most important thing when they work on. What? Next to that, collaboration and communication is difficult. Students find it very difficult to communicate and to collaborate, but not only students. I think adults have the same problems. So I started this in August 2011, only with the paper, what I do in the beginning, and I was very surprised. It works. I give the students the freedom to work for themselves. And I was discovering that I was not only the source of knowledge anymore. The students have a lot of potential things in themselves. So, what I did to my students, I gave them trust and a lot of freedom. But not freedom without borders. Freedom is very good. Everybody wants freedom. But built on trust. When you don't trust your students, that you think that you have to put the knowledge into the students, forget it. It won't work. And what I told you in the beginning, I teach for 43 years. I have little experience. So you know these three pillars? I change a little bit. What do I change? Investigation, yes. Transparency, okay. Adaptation, okay. But in the middle, there was inspect. In the Netherlands, inspect is a negative word. I don't know how it is in Turkey. Inspector is coming. The inspector is coming. So, but I learned something also. Investigation is more convenient. But I did it 2 weeks ago in Moscow. The same poster. And when I say this investigation, inspect was not good. Investigation was not good. Reflection. Yeah, okay, but a more positive word. But this word was not good there for the culture, and also inspect, not good words. So, and maybe we can, what we are doing with Scrum, more important, agile way of thinking, maybe we can change the way of education. It takes a long time, very long time. And what is the secret about the whole, what is the secret about this? What do I give to my students, do you think? What do I give to my students? Please? Yes, but freedom, okay, what more? In the beginning, in the picture was, they determine the how they want to work. But what is most important, I give them ownership of their own learning process. Creativity. They do what they want. I don't tell about 6-7 weeks, you have to deliver this for the test or whatever. And then they do it in their own space, in their own sequence. Yeah. So, and as a teacher, yes, as a teacher, I tell them, I start here with the assignment, and at the end, we are finished. But then they dive under, like waterfall, and the results, mostly bad. Or when they work 2 days before the test, they get good results. But what I do is here, I do short iterations that I put them out of water, and I call this the review moments. They show me what they have to do, what they have to learn at that time, and they show it to the other teachers, students in the classroom. So every team tells it to the other students, so they listen and they learn from each other. So this is the process, how it works. The process you see also on this poster here. Here is a teacher, product owner. But you know, product owner and Scrum Master, can you combine them?
No.
Yes, as a teacher, yes. Yes, as a teacher, you can, because you are the product owner from the product you have to deliver with the students, and you are also the Scrum Master because you have to manage your teams. But in Scrum, it is forbidden. But I change a little bit, so he's product owner and Scrum Master, but I don't use the word master. Who's the Scrum Master? Who's the Scrum Master from you? Yes, I too. I changed my name, Scrum Coach. I like Scrum Coach better than Master. Master, ooh, then I know everything. This is the team. This is not the Scrum Master, this is Team Captain. I call it Scrum Master Team Captain. That is not so heavy. And this is behind this. Oh, here. Here's the assignment. So, I could do next. Who can read Japanese? What's the standing here? Sangen. San means three. There's a Japanese word, and I make them in a criteria. The box is about how to set the criteria for the students. The focus, here can you write the focus. The focus can be on the assignment, the theory, the project. The focus can be on the person or in the class, or the focus can be on the team. That's the focus. And the circle around can also turn the upside down way. So when the teacher coming into the classroom and he wants to teach his theory for 10 minutes, because mostly when I teach it's only 10 minutes, and then it's finished, then they can work for themselves, and I walk through the class with the teams. And but one of the teammates, one of the person is sick. And he is very sad. So I have to take my focus to this student here. Or when the team doesn't work very well, I have to focus here. But my plan was, I have to teach my project. But I have to change my plans. You must be agile in that way of time and with that moment. But that is all about knowledge. And with this focus here, I focus my personal goal here. And here from my passion, from my heart, is personal development of my students. I want to see them grow. I want to see them that become people who know who they are and what they want to become. So my goal is to create people who are well known each other, themselves. I create a safe environment, I give water, I give them food, I give them tea, I give them coffee. This kind of stuff. Now I have a test for you. And we do this with stand up and sit down. Hand raising is too slow. And we do it fast. And I take out one, two, three team captains. One team captain come forward. One of four. One team captain. You here? No, you here. You don't want to work with them. You here and you at that side. Yeah. You stand, okay. Now listen well. We have to make your team. I ask their qualities. You must pick out the best qualities to form your team. Clear? Who can be a leader? Stand up, a leader. Quality is a leader. Wow, one, two leaders, three, four. Are you a leader?
Yes.
Oh, then you must don't pick them. Are you a leader? Yeah, team captain. And you a leader? Agile coach. Maybe you can use a leader. Okay, we go to the next. Sit. Who's a good planner? Planner, planning, one, two, three, stand up to make active, please. Four planners. You remember them? Okay. Organizing, who? Wow. Sit, researching. Who's a good researcher? One, two, three, four, five. Designing. Who's a designer? Nobody? Okay. Presenting. Who is a good presenter? One, two, three, four, five. Five. Okay. I think she can everything. And she also. Ambitious. Who is ambitious? One, two, three. Okay. Intentional. Responsible. Sorry. Responsible. Three, only three, four, five, six. Positive. Who is positive? Okay. Creative. Wow. Reliable. That's important. Then helpful. One, two, three, four, five. Only women? No, two men, three men. Okay, four. Welcoming. Okay, improvise. Who can good improvise? Improvise, only one? Persistence. Okay, thank you. You see the qualities of your team. Can you now choose a team? Oh. Oh, can you now choose a team? What we did here, we know nothing. Now you listen to the colors of the different qualities. You're making the team together, and they're going working together, and they deliver the project. I have to improvise a little bit with this kind of stuff because normally you do it the other way. In the workshop, I did it the other way. Please sit down. Thank you. So, applause can later to them. So, here you see the most important thing. What is what you have to use for working in a team? You know him? You know him? Lencioni? Lencioni, but this is not Lencioni, but I adjust a little bit. Trust is the most important thing. When there's no trust, there's no communication. When you have a good trust, you can be yourself, you can communicate. You have conflict. You can have conflict here. But these two blocks are very, very, very important. When this work together in a very good way, take care of this, then commitment is an organic result. And when these three blocks are working, then accountability for the whole team is normal. That happens. These two blocks is important. This happens. And the results, the outcome is very good at that time. I forgot one thing. When you work in a team, what do you must a little absence of? What? Just, oh, here below must be something what you get a little bit rid of. What? Tell me. Ego. Yes. Because when my ego is very big, I don't have followers. And you can't do your work alone. Can only do your work as a team. So, when you teach your students and give them a purpose, And one of the purpose I give my chemistry students, I chemistry teacher too, I give them a cell phone. Everybody had a cell phone. And I ask them as an assignment, how many copper is in the cell phone? They must break them down. They must do chemical stuff with it. They have to calculate it. And next to that, why is recycling so important? Why we must recycling the metals? Well, why must we recycling plastics, this kind of stuff? This assignment is it copper. It must be good for the profit for the people. So you must get money. You must health for the people. And the other is it must be good for the planet. People, planet, profit. So we make them critical thinkers about what you have to do. So now, what you're now seeing is my students are working. My students are working to make their plan. So they give an assignment. So they put all sticky notes, tasks, on the board. Different kind of stories. Every story has his own celebration criteria. And the three important word of a story is, what are the three important words? As, want, so that. Because every student had to write his own as, want, to that. For every story. Four stories, four, as, want, so that. And for every as, want, so that, there are, when the story is well and good enough, then the celebration criteria, the criteria where they have to work, oh, here's the criteria where they have to work for is very crucial. You are in it. And you, in Scrum, it's called, how it is calling in Scrum? Accept. Do you want to, you have to accept this. Clear? It's not positive. My student changed it. I didn't change it. Say, so don't like the word acceptance criteria. I don't want to accept what you tell me. How must I change? I changed it since 1 year ago, 15 months ago. My children don't like it, acceptance. So I changed it. Must print it out again. So this is very important. Do this kind of stuff. And I also make two different assignments, working agreements. Working agreements, definition of doing, it's not definition of done. And the students make also doing is because there were agreements to meet. The task must meet the celebration criteria, so they make agreements on how they want to work together with each other. And also the fun factor. Fun is, I think, more important than definition of doing. When you have fun, real fun in your team, and you celebrate it, then you create a lot of workflow. So everybody knows planning program. 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 30, 21, 34, etc. When I start with small, medium, large, XL sizes. It is faster, and when I go into the details, I use the planning poker cards. And to create a run-up chart, not burn down, students don't like it, run-up, 2 years ago, also this change, 2 points, 5 points, 8 points. More than 13 points. This task is too big, so I have to make it smaller. So here there are, you see here, a lot of sticky notes. A lot. And there is an assignment that was a copper assignment, yes. And they make sticky notes, and what the sticky notes, what don't fit on this column, so I put an extra paper, and when this column is going to done, this become empty, and they put this in this column, and they go on. So, here you see planning poker cards. In the beginning, I don't have planning poker cards for myself, because there was an app. But there's also a problem, because the cell phone for the students are empty, or the memory is full, so we can use the We can use always the cell phone, so I have used the cards. They like it very much. Yeah. This is, for instance, you can read it, you can't read it, but this is a kind of definition of doing, definition of fun combination, is they want to have a mark bigger than 6.7 on a scale from 0 to 10. They're going to work very hard and doing their best. They don't go working with other teams. They make a summarizing and making all the questions. And I don't know what he's standing here. And here is a very don't fuck. That's what's standing here. That is what they say. They want to be serious. This is a storyboard with celebration criteria. We see the run-up chart. They're going in the workflow. When the students come into the classroom, they put the flaps on the wall, and they do the stand-up. So here are students who counting the points, what you have done. You know the stand up. What have you did since last time? What are you going today? What are your impediments for today? What do we need? So calculate the points, and they put things from to do to busy. And then I walk through my classroom, and I go to teams and ask what they need. And they ask me a question, and that is very crucial, when there's a team of four people like this, and you ask me a question, and I ask, my first question is, did you ask it and your teammates? No. Sorry, I walk. First, ask your team. When the team don't know it, then they come to me. Here they are working in my class. What are we having here? Yes, sorry. Here's a technical project for physics, chemistry, also technical stuff. And my flaps are here on the wall. On the wall, yes, with magnets. The run-up chart. This is for me a very good, and also not only for me, but also for the students, a very good way to see what is happening. When the line is like this, the teacher don't do his work. So the teacher don't do his work. When the line is flat, then here on this time schedule, we have to ask to go to the team, what is happening here? So, and then maybe they need support or they do nothing. When the line goes straight up, then also you have to change a little bit to check if the quality of the work is very well. That is also very important. So it must be around this line. When they are finished, they put the map into a folder and they go out to the next class. This is also a testing moment for a practical way. In this case, they build a bridge from paper and testing how many loads a bridge can have. This is a retrospective, but a retrospective not on the product. For Eduscrum, we do a retrospective on the product, on the way of the test or the project, the presentation kind of stuff. But this is a retrospective about the personal development. It starts with the up. Yes, here. What did you do? What went well? What do you think? What went well? What can you do better? What must you do better? And then you collect all the what went well, what must we do better as a team, and then you go to the action points individually and as a team. And then what kind of qualities you bring in for your work. And how many trust, the last question here, how many trust do you have in your teammates? That they have to talk about with their fellow teammates. So at the end, we do the retrospective. Then make it visual. I give them a blank paper and they draw something like this. And here, on this side, here, they draw the qualities they have starting in the beginning, what you did also. And so, was in the beginning. And here they put the qualities they use. When they discover a new quality, they put it in the box. When they use the discovered quality, a little bit it come here. When they use the new qualities, they put them in the center. And after that, they write a report about their way of working. And the results. Yes, the results in the beginning stay the same. Maybe 0.1, 0.2 less on average in the beginning. But there's a difficult difference. I don't teach as much anymore. The students did it by themselves. The personal development results go like a rocket. They know who they are. And most of this, they are ready with their task in time. My students are 4 or 5 lessons earlier finished in every period. That means 2 weeks. The first year of chemistry, they have gained 6 weeks. That means 12 to 14 lessons, a whole period. I was finished in April, and the school stopped in June. So we have to do nothing. Now, then I can give them a real project. So my students have fun. You can see it. It is not go to the picture and look what is happening now. They have really fun. Little retrospective about the cell phones. Have you learned something today? Oh. Who learned something today? Okay, what do you learn?
The whole day?
Yeah, no, only from me. One word. I ask everybody, one word.
Okay,
is one word.
Words are important.
Important.
Words.
Words.
Are important.
Yeah, thank you. Next. Ooh.
Me.
Sorry.
Creativity makes difference.
Wow.
Without trust, there's no communication.
Wow. Next.
Learning must be have fun. Must be fun.
Nothing? Okay.
Celebration criteria and definition of fun.
Okay, I have only a few minutes left. I go, you know these principles and values from Scrum? I change it also a little bit. I make values, when values are become very, very important and don't miss them, I put them into the principles. And I put some values also into the some words also in the values, what are very important. And when you go to my website, you see this kind of compass. We created this in the US in 2016. And did when you understand this compass with the text, you can use it for your way of agile way of working. The most students who I work with don't work with this yet. This is very complex. And the text you see here, you don't have to read it, you can download it. Both. Oh, sorry. Finished? Sorry. Thank you. Do you have questions? Give I all answers to your questions?
Oh, thank you. So I just want to ask, how did it start? Who did you have to convince? And how did
No. Don't convince.
No convince.
Okay. No.
Negative
show.
Word. Show. Okay.
Show. Other teachers. For students also not. Students have to do what you want. But when you convince other teachers, you get a conflict. Only show what you're having in your classroom. And then they can look. For teachers, but I think also in the real world, three kinds of people. We have pigs. I'm a pig. I work hard. We have chickens. Only put an egg. And you have kind of pigs with, I don't know the name, pickles.
Hedgehogs.
Yeah, leave them alone. And don't convince, show. Show the happiness in your classroom. Oh, I see myself. Okay, next.
Hi, why didn't students like the burn down chart?
Why they don't like it?
Yes.
I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know. They don't like it, but burn down is negative, but why? I ask my students, my six, seven classes, what do you like when some classes come up with this change? Do you like run up, or burn down, or run up? Now, the most students choose for run up. It's more positive, go to the horizon. The step on the point on the horizon.
Okay, thanks.
How do students get adapted to the other lessons when they have so much fun in yours?
Again, please.
How do your students get adapted to the other lessons? Because they have so much fun in your lessons, so
yeah.
And if the others aren't doing it,
I know. What's happening that some teachers become jealous. And they say, my students, for the English teacher, for instance, work not hard, they do a lot of work for you, and then they are tired when they are in my English class. That is your problem, not mine. And also, I don't only teach for 10 minutes, 5 or 10 minutes, and then I walk it to my classroom. I support my teams. Last year, because I have less time, so I have to teach 60 students at the same time. It's impossible. But when you have 11 teams, you go to the one team, to the other team. Normally in a classroom, you can walk and sit and walk and sit. And then With 11 or 12 teams, you have constantly walk in 15 minutes. So that is the difference, but you can teach them. And you give them ownership. You give them ownership for their own learning process. And they, it is their choice. And when it don't, when one student is not, is bullying or don't work, I go to communicate with the team. And when they don't want to listen, I take him out. And he do this work for themselves. Next period, it is not a punishment, but next period, he asked me, can I join the group again? It's like, I don't know, ask my students. Ask them. And sometimes the students say, no, we don't want you. But it's not for me. That is, he deserved it. I don't punish him, he punishes himself. Punishing don't work. I'm finished. Thank you.